Bridge is broken.
That's all right. I've had enough of your hospitality already.
I have changed my ways, all right?
Huh?
Yeah, I'm done with that crazy shit, all right? I want to square things away with Meriwether, make sure the agency ain't coming back after us, and then do one last big score, and then you get to go back with your family. Me, I'm just going to live here. I'm going to run this good business, showing people a good time. Bust Brad out of prison, and then, you know, happy.
So how'd you come by this place anyway?
I've had it for ages.
So you must know Leon, the old manager.
Leon? No.
Yeah, whatever, man. So what's going on here?
What's going on is the big one. A long, long time ago in a faraway place, there were three guys. Michael, Trevor, and Lester.
And Brad?
Yeah. Sure, Brad was there sometimes as well. I mean, there were other guys, though, too. So, anyway, we robbed and lied and we hurt people. Pretty much lived a low-life kind of existence. But always dreaming of one thing and one thing only.
The big one.
The big one.
The big one!
What is the big one?
The Union Depository.
Around 200 million in gold bricks, all taken from kindly Uncle Sam, who will spend the rest of our lives being hunted by government officials if we live through the attempt. But...
what?
It'll be my, our masterpiece. So, gentlemen, let's do our civic duty and get out there and find some gainful employment. This way.
Let's go.
Big one.
Strict schedule. There's a couple of armored cars and a dry run to the depository. Intel suggests they'll be going down Innocence Boulevard in East LS at approximately 15:30. Trevor and I need to map their route for a possible hijack point, so we're going to his airfield in Blaine County and coming back in his chopper to intercept. Michael Franklin, all you gotta do is take the temperature at the bank, see if there's anything that stands out.
Hey, we are taking the temperature.
Yeah, you know, getting a feel for it. Security, exit routes, general vibe.
All right.
That doesn't look like much.
Man, security looks light. We send in a couple of sprung niggas, clap, clap.
What are you talking about, Frank?
Oh, I see it. Man, getting in the door is easy. It's a standard bank. It's getting underground as hard. Ain't that where the metal's kept?
Right. Now we gotta stop outside the Arcadia Center down on Alta Street. We can get a view of the back from there.
Hey man, you might not notice it, but I picked up a few things rolling with you. I mean, there's times I think I gotta be the senior partner in the group. From the way you and Trevor behave.
Ah, sorry. There's history there.
Yeah, it still ain't fully been explained to me though.
No? Well, remind me to go over with you again sometime, but not now.
How you doing, man?
Look, dog, light again, man.
Yeah, fucking eerie, ain't it?
Man, you think they put more than one motherfucker on our national fucking reserves?
Yeah, huh? Well, maybe we really are broke. Trevor, how are you doing?
Clockwork, Mikey. Like clockwork.
Four kids running happy on a beach, ignoring the dead mammals and stricken seabirds washing up from the latest oil spill.
You mentioned a job before. Something I could help you with?
I ain't even talked to Mike about it yet, but he's gonna be on board. He's obligated.
What is it?
Ain't it obvious? Busting Brad out of the clink.
Why do you talk to Michael about it?
Oh, fine. Shit. I was gonna pay you, man. When there ain't an obvious profit in something, you're a hard guy to motivate.
Oh. 1330. We're an hour down, two to go.
You're the one who keeps talking about the schedule, Les. Come on!
Mike's observations stick with your scheme. So far, yeah. The security's internal rather than external. It's quiet enough that any disturbance is going to get picked up immediately. But what those two don't know is there's a special team of cops on standby 24-7 waiting on a signal from the UD. Won't go out on any other call.
And it's never been hit. Man, those guys must get bored.
But they work for the government. There's nothing government workers love more than to accept tax dollars for doing nothing. Oh, yeah, that and spying on innocent people.
Getting paid to do nothing and spying on innocent people. Now, who does that remind me of?
Anyway, if we want to hit the vault in a way that people will notice, the key will be to divert the security team.
Divert it? You said they hold out for calls from the UD and that's it.
They do, so we'd have to hit it twice, once to distract them, and once to get it done.
You're gonna find someone willing to get caught hitting a super bank just as a distraction?
I was thinking, Michael, it might appeal to his ego.
Oh, what am I saying? We got the perfect guy for it.
I'm picking up the cars. Right on time. Hey,
IDs to get in the building this way. I'm assuming that's doable, Les. IDs I can handle.
Onion 86 in sight. Stand by. Hey, I was expecting you 30 seconds ago. Tell that to the traffic.
All right.
Onion 86 in the building.
Now, if I remember from planning the tool store job, they're excavating the new LS Metro Tunnel around here. They take us around the building and find the construction site.
Roger that! Looking for a big asshole!
That's the excavation! I need you to hold the chopper above it while I take a look. Hover up, Bob, so I can... Now just hover here! It feels like they've been digging this tunnel forever. That should hold some weight. No hints at supporting structures for the vault walls. Lots of clear space. All right, I think I've got enough information to work with.
I got two ideas. It's gonna take a while to get them together and work them up, but I think there's a way. It's not impossible.
All right. We'll start thinking about the breakout, too. Bradley Snyder. He's getting bored.
Talk to Michael, okay? Goodbye.